The Minister of Transportation, Rotimi Amaechi, says China has been very helpful to Nigeria. The minister noted that the Republic of China and its people have been very helpful to the federal government following the disbursement of cash to fund infrastructure, especially railway. Amaechi said the Asian country released $1.6 billion for the Lagos-Ibadan Railway and is expected to approve $5.3 billion by October. The minister added that hopefully by October they should be able to approve the $5.3 billion for the federal government of Nigeria for the commencement and completion of the Ibadan-Kano Railway. And joining us via Zoom is the former Commissioner for Transportation in Lagos State and former Transportation Secretary in FCT, Kayode Okpefa. Good evening, sir.
Yeah, good evening.
Thank you for joining us. And we go straight into the matter. How strategic is this partnership with China in nation's railway transportation sector? Because when an average Nigerian hears of loan, it sends shivers down their spine.
Unfortunately, for infrastructures like rail that runs into billions of dollars worldwide, is always financed by a third party, usually through loans or through bonds. And more importantly, for a country like Nigeria, we don't really have that much in our Federal Reserve. So the option left for us is to go for a third party funding, that is via investment or through loans. Now, strategically, you will recall that this project started a long time during the time of President Obasanjo, but for lack of funds, nothing could be done. This is the coming of President Muhammadu Buhari and the current minister, former Governor Amaechi. There has been a lot of enthusiasm and passion, and that has brought the Chinese loan, which has been used to complete, as I speak to you now, the Lagos-Ibadan rail line, which they got 1.6 billion junction and is on its way to land at the Lagos port. Also, the current loan we're talking about, the $5.6 billion, for the completion of the Lagos-Ibadan, which will take you to Kano. The Kaduna-Abuja section had also been completed, also via a Chinese loan. And also, in addition to that, you have the Abuja rail system, which is also completed. All these have happened in the last 5 years. So it is so strategic in the sense that it will allow for improving the mobility of the country, and it will improve the mobility economy with huge return on investment in various other sectors. When your economy is mobile, when people can move from one place to the other at will with the time they want, at a reasonable cost, you can move goods, you can move freight, you can move haulage, then you have a fluid economy, which we call the mobility economy. Yeah. And with the mobility economy comes advertisement, investment along the corridor, real estate investment, property investment, strategic investment, productive ops around the corridor, housing estates around the corridor, mm-hmm. and so many other things will come. More money in people's pockets, more money for government through IGRs and all these sorts. So all right. It's very strategic, and believe me, it is the way to go.
Now, what's your assessment of President Buhari in the mode of transportation, especially the talk about monorail and light rail projects?
Yeah, thank you very much. You notice that the most part of our transportation system has been through the roads, and that's accounting for over 90% of the way we move people and goods. The air sector is moving a lot as well, but not significant enough. But the rail sector that is supposed to play a significant part in long-distance movements, north-south, east-west, east-north, and the rest, is not that developed. We have been operating through the narrow gauge. Now, with the coming in of this administration in the last 5 years, significant investment in the standard gauge. And believe me, it has never been this good. The worry is that we are just already rolling stock on ground to start moving people as soon as interstate movement is removed and the Ministry of Transport and the Nigerian Railway is ready. Same thing for the Lagos-Ibadan sector. You can imagine moving on that line, one of the busiest lines anywhere in Nigeria, and comparable to most other standard lines in the world, moving people from Ogun State, moving people from Oyo State down into the northern part of Lagos to the economic center of Lagos. You also have the Abuja light rail, which is also ready, new rolling stocks brought in. then you now have the Lagos Kano line to be extended from Ibadan down to Abuja and from Kaduna down to Kano. There's nothing less you can ask for. And possibly the completion of the Ibute Meta to the Lagos port will also aid the movement of cargo into the airport and from the airport to all other parts of Nigeria. Surely speaking, that will open up the country, open up the economy, because transportation, mobility economy will be next to power in terms of rating of what this country needs to do. And with the great work being done by the Ministry of Works, Federal Ministry of Works and Housing, rehabilitating the roads.
Right. How realistic is this dream of the government with the economic setback which COVID-19 has posed? Do you think they can achieve anything substantial?
Yeah, the COVID-19 impact on the economy is going to be global, and Nigeria is not going to be an exception. Definitely, there's going to be some setback, but let me say this. We are even lucky that we have started early enough, and I believe, and most of these projects are already at their completion stage with the rolling stock on ground. I think it will aid the economic recovery plan of the government, because mobility would be enhanced. And when mobility is enhanced, the spending ability, the revenue generation ability will improve. So I see it as it will affect us a little bit. The economy will be affected, but it should not disturb the program.
Thank you so very much, Kayode Okpaifa, for your in-depth contribution and analysis there.
Thank you very much. Thank you for having me.